How do I sonicate my chromatin in the enzymatic ChIP protocol? I'm Fang Chen, senior scientist in the ChIP group at Cell Signaling Technology, and this is CST Tech Tips. CST has two ChIP protocols for chromatin fragmentation. This video covers the enzymatic protocol, which despite its name, still requires a brief sonication step to break open membranes and then release chromatin. If we are performing ChIP with the sonication protocol, refer to our other video, since the sonication is harsher in that protocol. Both protocols have some general tips. First, always keep samples on ice during and between sonication cycles to avoid warming up. Second, insert the tip of the sonicator probe to the bottom of the tube and adjust the sonicator settings, like amplitude, to avoid bubbles during sonication. Otherwise, your target protein could get denatured and you can lose your ChIP signal. Now, focusing on enzymatic ChIP protocol. The chromatin has been fragmented by micrococcal nucleus, so only brief sonication is required to release the chromatin fragments. If you're working on a half-mil sample, expect to see a very small pellet of insoluble material after spinning down the sonicated samples. If a large pellet, roughly 10 or more microliter, is observed, this indicates that the nuclei are still intact and you should further sonicate the sample. Thank you for watching. You can find four protocols for all applications on each antibody's product page at cellsignal.com. If you have any questions about an antibody or protocol, you can get in touch with one of our scientists at cellsignal.com/support. Don't forget to subscribe for new Tech Tips videos, and we will see you next time. Good luck with the experiments!